Hey guys, welcome to the Gaming Den. That nostalgia wash over you for a minute. All right, that's enough. All right, everybody, hello and welcome to another nostalgia trip episode. First, let me just say I've changed up my theme for that. I'm going to call things that I plan on doing one episode for a nostalgia trip. And then if I wanted to actually do a little series on it, but I'm going to call it a nostalgia episode, then it'll be a nostalgia vacation. I feel like that makes sense. You know, if it's temporary or short, it'd be a nostalgic trip. Then if it's like long term, it'd be a vacation, which is like how families do, you know, because we're a big family here. And also, like a family, if I get enough requests for it, then we can turn a trip into a vacation. So I could do something like that. But yeah, I just plan on playing a few games from this and see how, well, kind of just more reminiscing on it. Also, I guess it'd be a good experiment to see how many copyright infringements I can get in one game. Sure, most people that have played this, the pick is gone. I have no idea. I never finished this game. No, I definitely finished this game. I have definitely finished this game. I think some of my progress got reset. That's okay. I wasn't trying to go here anyway. I forgot where to go. It's party play. That's where I want to go. So, my absolute favorite thing to play on this game was always Entertainer, which is why I say this would be a good experiment to see how many copyright infringements I can get in one video. Because I'm pretty sure if I play this, I'm going to get all the copyrights. I don't know. Maybe the songs have been out long enough to where I wouldn't. Maybe. But let's warm up with something easy. This is easy. When I get back up on the mic and you'll be running when I'm coming like I'm out there stealing bikes. Pack it up, pack it up, give me some. I definitely need to warm up because I haven't played this in a while. And I don't know how well this controller works. I had a authentic PS2 controller. I don't know where that went. So I'm using a generic brand PS2 controller. I really have to find my PS2 controller because it was really good. This analog is a bit janky. It gets the job done though. This is probably a mistake. Yeah, I can definitely see that's a mistake. I'm gonna have to use the bottom analog. It seems harder than I remember. I thought that was me that messed up. I was gonna say, I did not. I'm getting perfect. So how many people used to play Thrillville when they were younger? I remember when it was first showed off on ads and stuff, it was like a pretty big deal, I think. Maybe. It was to us. I mean, we couldn't wait to get the game. And this song was my life. I think my brother was the one that wanted this game. This is actually his game. He doesn't really care for games like he used to. He plays FPS and shooters and stuff like that, and some racing games. So games that he doesn't really play anymore, I just kept. You know, someone has to use it. Also, I don't know how I missed earlier. Wait, where are my holes? Why do they have holes and I don't? You see them holding and I'm not? Why is that? Is it because I missed one? No, their whole thing is different. Why is it different? I knew this song seemed weird. Hold on. Something's wrong. I knew it seemed easier than I remembered. I put it on hard. Difficulty hard. Battle. Real to me. Does it matter who I pick? It shouldn't. Everything's still set. Three opponents. Like, I hadn't played this in a while, but I knew something felt weird. I usually don't forget rhythm games. Like, that's one of the things that are instinctive to me. And the buttons aren't matching up. Like, the computers are doing twice as much as me. Because it should be, like, two buttons per... There it is. Also, I just figured out why my rhythm is off. Because I'm using my computer to try to play this. So... What I see on the screen isn't matching up with what I'm hearing. It's like a split second off. That's gonna really confuse me. I just have to anticipate it and play like a half second ahead of what I would normally do. I won't do this for long. I thought I could use the Elgato now, since I have to edit my videos anyway. Include my intro. It seems that I cannot. Also, I'm very curious what happened last time. Why did it not be hard? Did the difficulty change? It couldn't have. The computers are doing hard. Good learning experience. Can't play rhythm games through my headphones. Not from my computer. Does my TV have a... If it does, I don't think it... I don't know, I'm gonna try that one day. I'm gonna see if my TV will let me use my headphones to it. They don't have a headphone jack, they have a USB jack. My TV probably won't let that happen. It has a USB port, but I don't think that'll work. Also, the computers might beat me on this because I missed, like, two. Again, the half second thing is really messing me up. Can't do it exactly with the music. I have to do it, like, a split second ahead. What's that? This shows that I have really good anti-rhythm. Or whatever you want to call it. This is not like a full second off, and I definitely would be feeling this. Remember when I was younger, my mission was always to try to get a full perfect on this song? I never did. I would always get one great somewhere, and it annoyed the heck out of me. Probably this part. To be fair, I never miss one. I'm only missing because the rhythm, again, the fact that it's a half second off, especially on that, that's the only reason I lost. What an embarrassment. Player 3 wins. Who cares? Well, I still somehow got 5 stars. Alright. So, I'm gonna switch my sound since apparently I can't listen to it from my laptop. I really thought I could. Because I've always played casual games with... When I was doing my Elgato thing, I never really tried to play a rhythm game from it. So now I know, can't play rhythm game from it. Give me 1 minute, I'm gonna get everything set up. Well, you won't see this, it'll be cut and play. All right, we're back. Maybe. I hope everything's okay. Maybe. It should be fine. Anyway, I'm gonna do two more of these. Well, one more on this one and another one on another mode. If anyone has ever played this one, they're probably figured out what I'm talking about. But I'll do another one on battle. And this time I wanna do this song. I like almost all the entertainer songs. I think just like one song I don't care for. Probably just one. I think you read a song I really like. I hit people with all the nostalgia. It was the music that really sold this game, I'm sure. The gameplay was okay. It was really the music. And the games. Definitely the games and the music. It was like trying to attempt to be a roller coaster tycoon game, I felt. But the roller coaster part of it wasn't really what was selling it for me. I didn't care for the part of it. Oh god, I forgot how this goes. Yep, side. I don't have to worry about compensating for the rhythm. Well. I used to do this dance in classes randomly. I just start bobbing my head and arms to this song. And people would look at me like I was crazy. And he's like, what are you doing? I'm dancing. It's a Banjo Boy song. They wouldn't figure it out. Also, I'm not normally this bad. I think it's because I'm talking, but I'm also talking over it intentionally just to try to reduce copyright infringement. Of course, I'm assuming that it's also picking up my controller clicks, so it should be fine. Oh, frick me. I have done absolutely horrible. That's okay. 4 stars? Yep, 4 stars. Ugh, that was horrible. Oh well. So now for the second phase. Now, if you've never seen this game, then now you know what Entertainer is. Now we're going to do Entertainer Turbo. So again, if you don't know what this game is, think the Chipmunks. And if you wonder why, you will see. You will see indeed. For other people that already know it, don't spoil it. Let's see. We're going to do a song I already did, so you have something obvious to compare it to. Also, this is one of the only songs I could probably do on Turbo. Okay. Got warmed up a little bit. Have you figured it out? The problem is the computers can't keep up. I do better than my brother did, though. Surely this song won't get copyright. Set. I did not miss that. Oh. that. I don't see these. Suck. This part is impossible. The last part is why I've never done perfect on this song. Still a lot of fun though. Alright, so now everybody's got some music in their stuck in their head for the day. Along with the chipette singing real to me. So let's play one of my favorite game modes. Me and my brother played the heck out of this one. There's really no point in choosing which level because it won't matter since I'm playing by myself. But if you have two players, then you can change it. So it'll be battle, which means the points don't... Like, whoever has the most points will win, and co-op is just both of you get to the end. So, and for this one, we need a shooter, so let's be a cowboy. I absolutely love the heck out of this game. This particular mode in specific. So, for those that haven't played, you have four different spaceships, spacecrafts, whatever you want to call them. And each one has different weapons, obviously. So you can see the description of what each one does. And if you hover over them, it shows you what each of them do at different levels. But it only shows you what their first weapon type does. It doesn't show you their second weapon type. In my experience, the best one is the plasma weapon, in my personal experience. My brother loved the storm lightning one. He is the absolute best for single target destruction. Yeah. So, he does like explosive AoE. His is a straight shot laser, so it just shoots everything in a straight line. Or you can have one that kind of sprays out. That's the second type. This one goes through everything and hits multiple targets. That's why I like it, because it can take out multiple things at once. Like, if you want to take out one single target, then use this guy. This one I don't really recommend. He's okay, but he's like a ramp-up damage type, because he's a straight-shot laser beam. So it's kind of like the plasma cannon, but that one does a ton of damage with a few hits. This one's just constantly, you have to stay on that target and basically shred them. And this one, explosive AoE is good, but it all goes in one direction. So you have to be facing in front of them, pretty much like him. And he faces in one direction too, but the plasma cannon has a bit more... It has more oomph to it, and it has more... What's the word? Radius? Diameter? Because you see on the rank 3, it kind of spread out. I'm explaining all this just to kind of tell you which ones to get. But basically, choose between blue or purple. If you want to be dairy, you can get red. If you just want to... Hate yourself and get green. It's not all that good. Now, if you want to win the game, probably blue. I haven't won it with the purple, I don't think. I've definitely beaten all three levels with blue. But because my favorite is the purple, that's the one I'm going to get. Okay, so... I don't remember which button changes your weapon type. Oh, well. I just got hit. We weren't supposed to die that early. Oh god. Okay, we gotta... No, I gotta keep going. Hold on. Wait, is there a restart? No, there isn't. Can you switch weapons? Oh, there it is. Okay. So this one does a little more damage because it's all focused in one place. If you want to rank up your weapons, you gotta collect all the little chromosome bits that they drop. They ship parts. I don't know what they are. I always thought they were like chromosomes. There it is. Okay, so now we can switch. Typically how everybody's rank one are level 1 and level 2 or whatever it is. What do you change weapon stuff? The first weapon will be a single direction, usually go straight ahead. And then weapon type 2 is usually a spray thing for AoE kind of stuff. Like this one, it just sprays around. This one is a homing type. And for the rank 1, it's a straight shot. And it pretty much one-shots whatever it hits. Okay. And it goes through everything, which is why I love it. The fire guy does similar damage, but it doesn't go through anything. It gets stopped by these asteroids, so you can't hit anyone through there. Ow. I'm getting dead a lot. So here's the boss. I've never died this much in the early stage. It's kind of sad. Usually I take him out faster than that. There we go. Alright, phase 2. Definitely gotta keep collecting these. You won't level up past 3, but you will at least get points and an extra life. And I definitely need that extra life right now. Oh, I already got one. I still need extra lives. I'm just gonna stick with this for now. Gonna be a lot of enemies just coming in from nowhere. I need to kill the ones that are coming behind this asteroid. Crazy how I haven't played this game in forever and I still remember. Oh my god. I still remember where most things are. You don't want to see what he does. Kill him as fast as you can. Oh well, you want to see what he does. The next boss is going to be a little tricky. I'm still getting lives back, so that's good. I'm still not accustomed to dying this much, though. Ooh. Ooh. Lasers everywhere. Definitely need this. The good thing is they take a while to actually charge up, so you won't get hit immediately by them. The red one is immediate though, don't get hit by that. The blue ones take a while, they just show the light of where they're aiming, but the red one is instant. Ouch. I don't even know why I was hitting them. Are you serious? Kill, oh my god! Just kill the stupid thing. Thank you. I got one life back. It's a good thing this game is very generous with lives. Now we're on level 2. That was level 1. All that was level 1. Upside, you're gonna get a good song. This is usually where my brother starts to dip out at level 2. Also, this is where the purple ship really starts to shine is this particular level. Because the problem with the blue one is that he has to be very close to do any real damage. Whereas the purple is definitely very good with rain. Ouch. Assuming I can stay alive. Oh, I knew not to stay to the top. Ooh. No. Stop. No. 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 God. Yeah, the blue one is a high-risk, high-reward ship. The purple is a more safe pick. The green is... I said it wasn't good, but it's a pretty safe pick, too. Because it has a good spray. And, like, I wish I could show it. I could show it. I'm probably gonna die soon anyway, so I can at least show it off a little bit. I want to do a full run with it. That snake is really hard to kill. Not impossible this time. The blue one would shred it though. Probably should show the blue one. Oh, oh, you died. Okay, well. I can show off the green one. I'm gonna just do like a quick preview of the green one. I'm definitely not doing a full playthrough of that. If you hate yourself, you can pick him. He's not horrible. He's just not the best. He's definitely the worst out of the four. See, this is his level one. He's very precise. You can get this one. Again, very precise. And you can see a lot of ships are getting through. He's not very strong. Level one isn't anyway. Level two is a little better. Bounces off. So I like that. I always thought it was pretty cool. And then this one becomes more focused. You're better off using this one if you have multiple enemies, obviously. Super laser. And then this thing. I call it the clap. But most of your damage is focused above and below you. It stays above and below you the most. Which is why I don't really care to use them. Because in front of you, you're pretty vulnerable. You would think with all those lasers clapping down, it would do some actual damage, but typically it isn't. On weaker ships, sure, is fine, but bosses, no, you're going to have a hard time. This ship is not good for bosses. It's good for clearing the area, and that's kind of it. Now, you can do this. That's pretty and all, but... Yeah, when are you going to ever be straight in front of someone to do it? As you can see, I'm kind of... having to avoid things, so I can't just focus. Oh my god. Focus on being in front of them. And their lasers are stronger. Let me see if I can even beat this guy. Probably not. As you can see, not doing a lot of damage. Oh god, just kill me. Just kill me. Like I said, if you hate yourself, pick the green. It is by far the worst. And now I'm gonna show off the blue. I have time. So this is the one where you can win the game. As you see, his range isn't fantastic, but that's also why his damage is so good. Typically one lightning bolt is all it takes to kill something. Also, I love the sound effects that they have for this one. My brother never used the first weapon type. He always switched to the second. Which is really where this ship starts to shine, is this. It focuses on one target and tears them to shreds. Which is why I said this is very good for boss fights, but like I said, the problem is he has to be in close to do anything. As far away, these things don't reach. So So the purple one excels in range. This one is good with single target shredding, but you have to be very good at avoiding getting hit. So evasion is your specialty. This is your ship. The upside, as long as it's something that dies pretty quickly, the ship won't let you down because it kind of kills everything pretty quickly. So any if something surprises you, like a ship coming up out of nowhere in front of you, it'll typically die before it reaches you. If it has a lot of health though, then yeah, you should stay closer towards this area so you don't immediately die. But this is one of the only ships that can even get this close and be effective. Every other ship kind of wants to stand in the back. Oh god. I really don't give you a lot of invulnerability frames here. As soon as you're able to shoot, you're not invulnerable. There's no point in this game where you can shoot and not take damage. Oh god. Nope. It's kind of bad. I said this was good at taking out bosses, but I'm losing to a boss. It's only because he is different. He has minions with him. And then watch this damage. See? He literally shreds every boss type. Oh god. But you gotta be good at dodging. He is not friendly for dodging. Just die. Thank you. Okay. We're still on level 1. At least his level 1 weapon has some good range on it. Pretty decent range. I don't think it reaches all the way to the end, does it? No. It's about half its range. It's probably over here. Ooh. Thought I was being smart going there, but that's where it went. Oh, bad lasers. Bad touch. No. Stop it. I like the purple more for this. Early game, the blue one has a hard time. Forgot that. The purple game wins all the way up to level 3. Then level 3 is where the blue lightning ship here is. Like the best. I've experimented with this game a lot to know all the really details. I'm on tier 2 weapon. I think I am. Yep, I was on tier 2. I died so much I lost most of my upgrades. Now we're back on level 2. But don't have time for that. This is where I will have to call this game. So next on our little nostalgia trip. I know all the things we used to play, I'm just trying to think which one I want to do next. We'll do something short. Oh, I forgot about this one. So another one that me and my brother always loved to play was this one. There are three types for this one. There's the space, the cowboy, and there are three, right? Or is it just two? Pirate. Space, cowboy, and pirate. Our favorite was the space. So robot invasion. The cowboy was fun too. The pyro is okay. The only main difference, aside from the enemy types, are the weapon types. But yeah, this one has really cool weapons. Now I can remember how to play. I'm gonna go for them headshots. I used to be good at just getting one single shot for a headshot, and I can't do that anymore. I can't even aim. Is this controller that bad? Or am I just that bad? Anti-gravity is beautiful. So the way this game works is all enemies will spawn in, typically it's like four or five of them spawn in one area. And it's kind of telling you where to go in the game. So you just have to keep going in that general direction. As long as you see enemies, that means you're going in the right direction. If you don't, that means you're going the wrong way. How do you change weapons? Okay. So this is the shotgun, I think. Very good. And your mission is to pick up all these little small things that I'm getting. So this one was almost always one shot. So I heard them pop up, but I just don't remember where all of them. Okay, there you are. Okay, well. I cannot aim for nothing. I usually just run through this. I'm not a speedrunner, but I could actually speedrun this game. Probably the only thing I ever spit run. Double shot. I used to be perfect at getting a headshot. Now I can't do that. I guess not playing a game for a long time really does hurt you. Who would have thought? In fact, there's no. Oh, there he is. This one isn't very good. Just two of the small weapons, but yeah, the shotgun is definitely the best. Perfect. Where are they? Where are they? I think they're inside. Can't remember where they pop up. It should be on there, so that means they're not in here. Oh, I forgot I have a map. Okay, so there's somewhere over here. No way they're back inside. They are back inside. How'd they spawn behind me? Oh, I got hit. Well, there's a health pack back here, isn't there? No. It's fine. I forgot this was time. Wait, wrong way. Not inside yet. I hear them shooting at me. They're shooting from inside. Now, can they see me inside? No idea. I forgot about these things. I'm missing one. Reminds me of my GoldenEye days. I miss GoldenEye. Okay, now they're up here. This is okay. You can aim with it. Just similar to the shotgun, it's like a one-hit killer, but it's precise. And I can't aim worth nothing. I charge stick with the shotgun. So I figure out how to aim again. Stop charging. Stop shooting at me. How can I get him one hit? There's somebody else shooting at me. I'm gonna stick with the shotgun. It's just better. I'm trying to show off that I don't suck at aiming, but I still suck at aiming. Also, my time's about to run out. Come on. I ain't even got all the robots. I failed at this. Ugh. My accuracy, I forgot they tracked that. I was like a 50-50 chance of hitting something. That is sad. Do not elect me to go and be on your Call of Duty teams. Whatever it is people play these days. PUBG? I think it's PUBG. Yeah, this one was similar to Event Horizon. I liked it. I think we have time to do like maybe two more. One or two more. Oh yeah, I forgot about you. Isn't there a Carwin somewhere? Oh yeah, this. I forgot about that. Sure, we can do this as our final game. This isn't as good as an actual full-fledged golf game, but it's still pretty good. There was a golf game we used to play, me and my cousins, back in the day on the PC. No idea what it was called. I don't remember who made it. It was very fun. Can you see the map? I don't remember. Probably not. I guess you just gotta assume where to hit it. Oh. Well. I mean, if I had known it was right there, I would have hit it there. Yellow jerks. Pulling two shots. So I can see the hill this time. Also, I see my time is not being kind to me. Oh dear. Game over. Well, that was fast. Okay, so. Again, it would be nice if I can see the map. Come on, you jerks. You absolute jerks. Okay, so. Does it need a little more power? Ugh. Need to be over to the right a little more. Okay, this one is tricky. I remember you. Too much power and it bounces off the middle. They did not refresh your time. That's why it's called a hole-in-one shot. You just have to get a hole-in-one or else you run out of time. Again, it would be nice to know where the hole is. I can do this. Can I see where the freaking holes are? Why can't I zoom out? Thank you. Okay, so I need to be closer to this side. Still miss. It would have been better if I didn't have so much power with it. Probably would have just swooped in. Too much power? Nope, just right. Come on. Booyah. Okay, where was this one? Okay, it's a sloop. Booyah. Ziggy zaggy. We want to hit it right about here. Well, I was almost there. Come on. Where is it this time? Oh god, this is impossible to get a hold of one. It's the worst place. This is the worst place. That's the furthest I can make it. Playing the hole-in-one challenge isn't fun. I didn't remember that they timed you on it. You can play it casually without the timer on you, but the hole-in-one challenge makes it so you have a timer. Well, I said I was going to end on that one, but this will be fun. More fun to end on. Something fun. That was stressful. That was horribly stressful. Battle. Dr. Funkle. Never heard that in a while. Just hit my mic. I apologize for that. Pretty sure it's going to show up. So I also have to change this. I only put in one CPU. Where is it? Here it is. Wait. Gosh. Freaking dang it. Single. If I play single, I think I race by myself, which isn't a race. If I play battle, I put in CPUs. So. No, this one. This is Dr. Funk, isn't it? Yeah, it's Dr. Funk. I think that was my brother's favorite song, Dr. Kunkle. If I remember how to play. Yeah, you have actual sharp turning on this. It's not like other games where you kind of just sling out. Where there's like real life where you can turn on a dime in a field cart. You know, you were swerving out, but you can't do it. Takes me back. Takes me back to the days of my youth. Made me and my family go to... Wait, do I have different gears or something? No, one gear, right? I think? Yeah, I believe so. I'm just wondering why they're so much faster than me. I don't remember losing this badly. It's like all my skills are gone from this game. It all does almost make me want to replay it, but almost. Not quite. It's definitely still going to be a nostalgia trip. I don't plan on making this a vacation. Although I'm still curious what happened to all my map save data. This memory card never got erased, so I'm not sure. Maybe it was on another memory card. Maybe it was on my brother's memory card. This is my memory card, which still begs the question of who the heck is Don. I guess someone played the PS2 when I was out or something, I don't know. And I just came in dead last. Oh, seems fitting to end on, huh? Last place. That's okay. I don't think there's anything else to really talk about with this game. It's just a game that I really loved playing when I was younger. Or I say younger, I'm not that old. Back in the day with my siblings. We used to play it a lot. So. I'm not planning on making it a vacation. It's just something, a little short video. Kind of tied over the week. But if enough people ask for it, I'll come back to it. I forgot about Monster. No, it wasn't Monster. Was it Monster Trucks? That's similar to the go-karts, but you're in monster trucks. The Trojan Quest is another one that took us forever to finish. I didn't know it had an end. I assumed it was just infinite. Then I noticed that the levels had one to four, and it's like, we never made it to the final level. It's so hard. It's crazy how this game has games within games, though. And that's why I love it. I guess it's not too different from Mario Party, but the whole point of Mario Party is to be mini-games. This one is like a game, and it has games in it. So, because the whole point of the game is to run apart and make roller coasters, but then it also has all these mini games in it. And some of these are like could be full-fledged mini-games. Like Trojan Quest that you talked about, that could be a game of its own. Somebody said, like, arcade-style mini-games. It was really good. Yeah, Thrillville was really good back in the day. I'm not sure how many people actually played it, though. Like I said, I think it was a pretty big deal back then when it was showing all the commercials, like the ad with the crazy, I think he was a scientist. I'm pretty sure it was a scientist that advertised it. He was talking all crazy and saying like how you're running the park. It's like children are running the park and that's insane. But yeah, it was a really good ad. I remember that. Or part of it. I might have to YouTube that later. Anywho, that's enough me rambling about the past. So that's going to be all for this nostalgia trip. Hope everybody enjoy. Do come back for another nostalgic trip. Whenever that is. I'm not sure how frequently I'll be doing these. I'm thinking maybe once a week. And then the other parts of the week I'll be focusing on one or two games. So, as always, have a howling good day.